You are not your own worst enemy. When it comes to diet and exercise, you can't possibly fight yourself and win. Today's video was inspired by a story that I was reading the other day where these guys were talking about these world-class investors. People who literally take like $30,000 and turn them into like hundreds of millions of dollars and so on. And people who invest for like 10 years and they don't lose money except for like on two occasions and things like this. And one of the things that the guy said was the reason why these men and women can be so good at this is because they are investing rather than gambling. And it occurred to me the other day that a lot of people are gambling when it comes to fitness rather than investing money and time and everything like that. Here are the differences, okay? First of all, gambling, high risk, low chance of reward versus investing, low risk, big and higher chance of reward. This was the main point that they were kind of making in the story that I was listening to, was they were like, you know, this whole idea of like big risk in order to get big rewards, they're like, forget that. The best investors in the world are the ones who are like, I want the most minimal risk that I can possibly get with the biggest reward, chance of reward that I can get. And they were talking about things where people would literally look for it and say, okay, if this doesn't pan out, I don't want to lose any money at all on this investment. I want 100% assurance that I can like sell back the product and get all my money back. And the potential reward is big. So think of gambling, okay? You go into the casino, you put money into like a pull handle, a slot machine or something like that. Your risk over time, it doesn't matter if you're playing penny slots or whatever, it's rigged so that the house wins, right? It's rigged so that your risk and reward ratio is always really thrown off. Yes, there's always the chance of reward, but really, casinos wouldn't be raking in literally billions of dollars a year if this was not in their favor and not in yours. But the investors are always like, I want the lowest risk with the biggest reward. The example that I can think of is, say someone's like, I want to start working out. I'm going to start walking or running more or something like that. The investor is going to say, all right, I've got these abilities right now. Okay, that's another thing is investment is about looking at the advantages you have right now. Gambling is about what do I have to spend right off the bat. If you're like, I want to start a walking or running program, it'll be like, okay, when can I do walking and running through my neighborhood? Oh, look, I've got a footpath. Do I have comfortable shoes I can walk in? Okay, I'll just use that. The gambler is one who's like, okay, I want to start a running program. I got to buy a treadmill. I got to buy these supplements. I got to buy this. I got to buy that. Got to buy that. So even before the gambler has even worked out once, they've already spent huge amounts of time researching things. They've spent huge amounts of energy asking opinions and everything. And they've spent unbelievable amounts of money on products and stuff. They haven't even done anything yet. The investor is saying, what's the cheapest way I can do this? Oh, I can start walking right now. I just go outside and walk. I don't have to buy anything. I don't have to ask anything. I'm just going to start and just take action with the least cost possible. That way, from day one, they're already way ahead of this person. Second of all, gamblers wing it. They rely on luck. They rely on rabbit's feet and good luck charms. And they're like, oh, I'll just go to some random place. Investors, they have a plan. Doesn't matter if it's a great plan. It's just a plan. They set out their calendar and they say, okay, I'm going to start my walking program and I'm going to walk half an hour these days of the week. When can I work that in my schedule? This will be at lunch. This will be after dinner. And these two times will be in the afternoon or whatever. They have a plan. They have something that they can do. Gamblers just wing it. They're like, I'll do it when I get to it. Never works out. Another thing too is gamblers rely on hard work. They have this method of if I put in enough time and energy and blood, sweat and tears and spend enough money, I'll get results. Never any promise of that. In many areas in life, but especially fitness, your results are not always dependent on how hard you work. Believe me, you can spend hundreds of thousands of dollars, you know, on equipment and everything and never get anything out of it. You can spend years working your ass off every single day and never go anywhere. Trust me, I've done it. Most people always do it. Never rely that just because you're working really hard, you're entitled to a reward. You see this all the time in companies and stuff. The person who gets laid off or they get passed up for a promotion and they say, oh, I've given this company 10 years of my life. You know, I worked the weekends and everything. I gave up my vacation, but this new guy who's been here for 6 months gets the promotion. What, you think hard work entitles you to success? Absolutely not, especially in fitness. There is no guarantee that hard work ever is going to produce you results. Investors, on the other time, rely on progression. They rely on progression. They're like, okay, I've got my plan. How do I progress it? So I'm doing things better. That guy who got the promotion in 6 months, he comes in, he looks at the systems in the workplace and says, okay, this is how I'm doing it. How can we make this better? And, you know, they offer a few ideas every week. In 6 months or, you know, 4 or 5 months, things are turning a much higher profit. And like, hey, Johnson, who we just hired, is doing a great job. Let's see what he can do in higher level positions. Your body works the same way. If you ask it to do things better, not just harder, it'll give you more of what you're after. Progression is what gets you results, not hard work. Yes, progression takes hard work, but you know, you run around in circles. It gives you the same thing day after day after day. But if you go steadily in a certain direction, that's what gets you there. It's like I tell every one of my clients, my job as a trainer is not to push you. My job is to progress you. Yes, sometimes it'll take pushing you a little bit, but you can push someone into the ground until they beg for mercy. There's no guarantee of progression. And finally, the gambler looks for tricks, the rabbit's foot, the good luck charms. You know, they try and what's the little thing that they've got that I don't have kind of ideas. This person, they focus on the basics. They're focusing on what has worked in the past, what has always worked, what is the basic stuff. They're not looking for anything fancy. The gambler, though, is sexy. The gamble is always the sexy thing within our fitness culture. This is the stuff that gets the press. This is the stuff that people tweet about and they put on Instagram within our fitness culture. Look how much I'm busting my ass. Look how much I'm changing things up. Look at how much I'm risking. I've just bought this $10,000 home gym. I've never worked out a day in my life, but you know, if I put enough money up front, that'll motivate me to work out. Never really pans out. Be safe. Be a wuss. Be boring with the investment. Nobody makes movies about guys who are investing in things, right? They make the movies about the people who go into the casinos and they lose their shirt. I've talked to some of the greatest investors I've ever met. I've got one guy who's literally hundreds of million dollars in investment. What does he do? He pores over spreadsheets. You know, his day is boring. His job is very, very boring on the outside. Why? Because he's looking at numbers. He's crunching formulas. It's nothing very exciting on the outside, but his, you know, $80,000 speedboat sure is very exciting because he's an investor. He does not gamble. He does his homework. He does not wing it. He's not looking for tricks. He's not going for the flash in the pan. He's going for the boring, the safe, and the easy as possible. And in fitness, that's exactly what you want to do. To live fit, live free.